It's treason because these people have declared war on our citizens by raping our women, our children, and murdering people like Laken Riley. You're familiar with her, right?
Congressman, our heartbreak.
Are you familiar with Laken Riley?
I am familiar with the case.
You should have deported her so that she could be alive today. Her parents would have appreciated that. And on that note, Mr. Mayorkas, I demand that Chuck Schumer holds your impeachment trial in the Senate, because that's exactly what we should be focused on right now.
I don't think the family of Laken Riley would have appreciated her being deported. But Marjorie Greene hasn't thought much about that, clearly. If you had thought that Laken Riley was just sort of a pawn in all of this, a convenient thing for a tiny brained person like Marjorie Greene to hold up as a get out of having to make a case for impeachment free card, I think she's demonstrating that about as thoroughly as is possible. It's catchphrase. It's a bumper sticker. She doesn't give a damn about her or her family. She's not even concerned with who should have been deported or to where or why. And that is the reason that Mayorkas needs to be impeached, because someone was murdered. It was a tragedy. Murders happen all the time. If we can identify murders under the next Donald Trump presidency, if he gets in there, Marge, do we get to impeach the Secretary of Homeland Security? Is that how this works? Is this a precedent that you're setting up, or is this a convenient position? That's sort of the game that we always have to play with this. The answer is always the latter, by the way. They're never stating a value. They're never demonstrating an ideology. It's never a principle. It's a, well, this sounds bad, so I think I get to win here, and then we go back to doing whatever we want. Now, she didn't correct herself later on, to be fair. One would think you'd do that eventually. I looked on her social media this morning. She still hadn't corrected herself. You know why? Because she doesn't care. She doesn't care at all about this. And I will not attempt to speak for the family of the slain. This, I will only say that if this were happening in relation to a family member of mine, it would bother the hell out of me. I have no idea if it's bothering them. But this is some tiny brain stuff going on for Marge, and also seems utterly pointless, as we'll get to.
Hey, I'm glad you're here. Listen, in order for the Damage Report to keep on going, we need viewers like you to become a member on YouTube. Can you click the join button on YouTube today? Thank you.
The point of this is they need to be able to say that the border is in crisis. How do you demonstrate that? Well, they don't seem to think that just showing the border is good enough, or else they just do that. And they've done that in the past. Oh, there's a caravan coming from El Salvador or whatever. They're not doing that. You could show the numbers. They don't seem to think that that's good enough, because they're not relying on that. This is shorthand, a shortcut. We're going to say it's so bad that we're impeaching him. Why does he need to be impeached? We're moving on. We're not talking about that anymore. But if we can just say he's potentially being impeached, then some people who don't pay that much attention to politics will read that as, I guess there's merit to it. I guess that's how bad it is. Now, if they were to pay a little bit more attention to politics, they might then say, well, then shouldn't they have passed that border security bill? And if it's treason for Mayorkas to be the secretary while a murder happens, how is it not 100 times more treasonous to see all of that happening, to be laser focused on it, and then to help kill a bill which theoretically might have stopped some of that crime from happening? So, okay, we can send to Chuck Schumer the Mayorkas impeachment documents, and they're doing that. And so we're gonna move forward on that. When are we gonna move forward on booting Marjorie Greene out of office? Or maybe worse, treason is a serious crime, and she is helping to assist the criminals that she says are flooding in through the border. I'm gonna be very interested to find out what happens with that process. But I wanna turn to you, Sharon. They are moving forward on this. They have delivered the impeachment documents out of the House to the Senate, and we'll turn to how likely that is to work. But what do you think about this?
Well, the last point you made is thought provoking, and that's exactly the argument the other side would use if the shoe were on the other foot. They would say something like that, and perhaps they'd be right. This is why you can't call Marjorie Taylor Greene annoying. It's beyond that. We've moved way beyond that. Laken Riley's father is angry. That's the father's angry that MTG keeps doing this. His daughter is an angel, he says, and he doesn't want her used for this political storm. She could care less about this American student, could care less about the border being overtaken by rapists and killers. She could care less. It's moved beyond annoying. This is a disgrace. It's harmful to all of us who are in within earshot of her. It's sick.
Yeah, she's not even good at it. There are politicians. Donald Trump, you know, he went to New York because the cop had been slain. So he went to be with the widow and the family, and he pretended for a moment that he cared about it. Ask him now what their name is, by the way. I would love for a reporter to do that. You think you'd remember that? But he did sort of like a photo op. He made it seem as if he cared. But Marjorie Greene will always be undercut by one inescapable fact, that she has shown no willingness or ability to change. She is a moron. She's one of the dumbest people ever in public life. It oozes out of every pore. It infuses every word out of her mouth. She is one of the dumbest people we've ever had to put a couple minutes of our attention towards. And so she thinks that she has this thing like, wait, if I just say Laken Riley, do you know Laken Riley? Do you know? Yeah, every freaking person knows the name of the person who tragically died. Some of them care, some of them don't, but everybody knows. She thinks, that's it. I don't need to make a case. And dullards like Marjorie Greene go through their life just looking for a shortcut. They know, they'll never admit, but they know that they can't craft a persuasive argument. Logic is beyond them. Reason, common sense is beyond them. They just want solutions to that. They want shortcuts past that. And she thinks that she's found one. She hasn't, okay? Because we can see through it. Just like we can see through one of the arguments they're using against Mayorkas, which is this BS argument that an NGO that he's tangentially related to is trying to get migrants over the border to vote for Biden. Again, one would think that that has nothing to do with why he needs to be impeached, because I heard it was about the treason because people were dying and being raped. But if that's not convincing, what about this NGO thing? And here's what I'm talking about. There's this flyer that's being tweeted out that's supposedly being distributed in Mexico, which is encouraging undocumented migrants to vote for Joe Biden. And you can see it right there. The issue with it is that it does not appear to in any way be authentic. So as is being broken down by a reporter for Fox News, Bill Malugan says, I am extremely skeptical of this. The flyer appears to be a word for word Google Translate copy and paste of a portion of the NGO's English website with vote for Biden randomly added in at the end when it does not appear on the site. The translation is bad in multiple ways. And then they badly Photoshop in a Biden logo. There's plenty of controversy with some NGOs, but this flyer seems fake or doctored even at first glance, unless you are one of the nation's worst dullards, in which case you don't have the capacity to tell if something is fake or authentic, if you even had the will to care about the difference. Marjorie Greene has neither of those things. And so again, even if this was authentic, this would not be an argument for why the secretary needs to be impeached, but it appears to be fake. And again, they don't care because they don't, it's when they talk about this sort of thing, when they spread this sort of thing, one would think they found it convincing. No, they find it convenient. It is convenient to fool the rubes with something like this. And so we'll get, again, I apologize, we'll get to whether this is likely to even work, but I've thrown some more evidence out there. So what do you think? I apologize.
Sometimes I don't know what to think anymore about this little twisted world that we live in. And about Mayorkas, right? When Marjorie Taylor Greene even addresses him and he kind of like stuttered just a little bit. I can tell you why. I don't know what you're talking about here. And that's across the board for the entire Republican Party and everything that is going on here. You make no sense, and yet we're reduced to, we have to do it, dissecting, unpacking. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say anymore. I really don't have time.
Well, because as you had pointed out earlier in the show that you've been around to watch a lot of this, you already know how all of this works. And I'll explain it in a way that maybe Marjorie Greene can follow, we'll see. If Laken Riley dies while Joe Biden is president, then that is cause to impeach the secretary. If Laken Riley dies while Trump is president, that's just a proof of how murderous these people are. So we need to clamp down on the border and give more power to Donald Trump and his Homeland Security Secretary. That's it. In the same way that if like a terror attack happens while a Democrat is president, that's because Democrats are weak and they invite terrorism. If a terror attack happens while a Republican is president, that's just a demonstration of how dangerous the world is and we need to give more power to the Republican president. That's how the filter is so simple for all of this. Okay, it's not nuanced in any way. It's simplistic enough that someone like Marjorie Greene can approach being able to understand it.
When you click the join button and become a tier 2 member, you get access to all of our weekly top 10 lists. What are you waiting for?